Hello, welcome back to Old World. So now I'll show you how to get that Tsar Stone in the Dark Ziggurat. The reason I didn't do this when I did the video for the Dark Ziggurat is because I wanted to test it more, and after testing it a couple of times and actually sleeping outside of the region, sleeping outside of the temple, no, it doesn't respawn. So it's a one time only Tsar Stone, kind of sad. So anyway, to enter the final door upstairs, you need to complete these two rooms, that one and that one. You just need to activate the corruption levers. After you activate them, you have to go up. And now you can use the elevator. It's kind of a tricky thing to do because you may die a lot of times doing this. But I'll try to do it the first time. So I had to do the testing with another character. No. Come back. Well, that was a mistake. But at least we can enjoy the view, so don't do that. That's a bad thing to do. Takes such a long time for this to come back. Yeah, so first thing, you have to step on the elevator. And after that, you have to jump to a ledge, which is this way, south. Face yourself south. I want to... Yeah, maybe I shouldn't take risks. So you get to see the full details of his masterwork, and after you pass the pipes, you can jump. No, actually, it's this way. Yeah, so it was to the north, actually. Interact with that lever. Interact with this one to call the elevator again. Again, this is very tricky because you may die. It was on the north side, sorry about that. It's kind of confusing, it looks almost the same. So press that lever, call the elevator again, and now you have to go to another location, which is one thing that threw me off, because you are supposed to get the Tsar Stone in here, I thought, but no, you have to go back to the other entrance. And you actually have to do one more combat before you get to the Tsar Stone, so yeah, it's a lot of combat for the Dark Ziggurat. So let's go back. I'm not sure, I think I killed everything in here. Oh no, I didn't kill everything in here because they may have respawned. Oh, let's see. And yeah, so this is the funny part. They actually nerfed how you get the Tsar Stones, but they didn't mention... Stop moving, guys. They didn't mention how you get the Tsar Stones now, because you need 25 in total to craft everything. Or at least 11 to craft the Tsar armor set. So yeah, you can only get about 5 Tsar Stones. So this is the corruption lever right here, the one you pressed before. And now this path is open. It looks clear, right? Yeah. Don't get your hopes up. You have to fight a sword golem. They're not so hard to fight, but they're kind of annoying. So let's not take any chances. Besides, they can combo you to death in a few seconds, so that's another problem. So turn off your lamp and start crouching. Well, I hear him, but I don't see him. Oh, he was hiding there. Oh, sneaky one. Sneaky or buggy one. Well, just in case you wanted to see the Blade Golem in a very, very good close-up. He's so gracious. By the way, it seems like the gold leeches create... That's a lot of blood in here. The gold leech is creating those golden minions and those golden things, and the jade leech is actually creating all the golems. And by golems, I mean the beast golems, the dog ones, and the stored golems, which is amazing because I didn't know where they came from. Another interesting fact, he killed some people over here. By the way, this guy is missing a leg. I think the others are pretty okay, but this one is missing a leg. That's very gruesome, a lot of details. So, you know, under Conflux Mountain in Cherzones area, in the heroic path, you actually find a derailed train who was carrying a lot of blade golems, and one of them is still intact, and you can attack him and kill him. But this means that the Lich had some kind of secret connection with the mages at the ley line, or something like that, and he shipped his golems all over the world. Whatever, that's some pretty interesting stuff. So they have been doing a lot of stuff. Ah well, if he's stuck, what can I do? Pork oil, crystal powder, and beast golem. So yeah, this is the Tharstone right here. So pretty. It actually has, it has a different shape than what you see on the picture, see? It's supposed to be a square stone. So yeah, that's about it. You get this stone, and now I tried to go to another region and sleep, but that didn't work. You also have an ornate chest around here. Hecmonite, Alpha, Tonosaur, Stealth, Survivor's Elixir, Palladium, Great Axe. Well, if we are here, we can check that out. This actually looks a lot more cooler than you would imagine. And it's lightning imbued. Speed is okay, impact is very very low, and the damage is kind of bad for a two-handed weapon. So yeah, not really recommended. But I don't know, I'll just have to see how many Tharstones you can get, or if they update the game to have additional ways of getting the Tharstones. So this has been the video, see you next time, bye! My characters say bye bye, boy.